So we are here in the Farming System Design Symposium, and we take this opportunity to discuss with our colleague Yeguzu Yeguzu from ICARDA. And I wanted to share with him some ideas about why today we need in the dryland system to design a new system for sustainable intensification to meet food security. And so what are the opportunities and the challenges regarding those issues? So if you can tell us something about these issues and what are the challenges and opportunities now for sustainable intensification in the dryland system.
Thank you, Hatem. Well, working in the dryland systems, we are basically facing lots of challenges, especially in terms of resources. And one of the major limiting factors in this region is water. So food security has a very direct relationship with productivity, which again is highly dependent on the amount of water that's available to you to be able to produce food. So we have a huge resource constraint in terms of water, but also the land productivity is very low in the dry areas, as these areas have been very much degraded due to a number of factors, including long history of cultivation. So food security indeed is a huge challenge in this region, and we need to come up with ways of sustainably intensifying our production system if we are going to be able to meet the food demands of the growing population in the region.
Okay, thank you. But what do you think about how you consider in your approaches and initiatives that you consider in your programs the heterogeneity of the farming system within this region? I mean, at least this is not an easy task. So how you consider this?
Well, the farming system in this region is not as straightforward as some people think. It is much more complex and has a lot of intricacies that need to be really factored in if somebody needs to fully understand the production system. This makes this systems approach very useful, as what you produce in the crop sector cannot be viewed in isolation from what you produce in the livestock sector, which is also an important enterprise in the region. There are also vegetables, fruits, and many other types of agricultural products that are produced in the region, and intensifying in one cannot be accomplished without due consideration of the others. Otherwise, we could be hurting ourselves by only looking at just one aspect of the production system.
Okay, I know from our collaborations, but also from the discussion that we got together, that modeling is a key issue. Can you explain for us what kind of model you use and why the model is a key challenge for ICARDA and for what you are doing at least?
Yes, well, in systems research, it's important that we need to understand that there are so many combinations of factors that need to be considered, and such huge combination cannot be experimented on, especially in terms of really on farm trials and so on, and without which you cannot generate all the necessary data that you need for modeling. Therefore, and of course for other analysis, therefore bioeconomic modeling comes into our rescue, because by using modeling we can be able to simulate for the scenarios under which we have not really done experiments yet, because this is a huge combination of possible interactions. Therefore, bioeconomic modeling becomes handy in terms of simulating for different possible combinations and exploring the potential of certain production technologies, innovations, policies, institutions, and market innovations. And bioeconomic modeling or systems modeling in general becomes very instrumental and useful.
I know from that we start working with the EAM and also with me at least. So can you say a few words about this collaboration and your expectation from this collaboration with the EAM?
Well, our collaboration with the CIHAM IAMM has started about two and a half years ago. And we came with very high expectation, given your long experience and hands-on current projects in systems modeling, including the courses that you guys offer. And indeed, we are not disappointed, and in fact, we are very happy in terms of the benefits our institutions are mutually really gaining, I believe, because there is huge complementarity between us and your organization, as your organization really has a good mix of expertise in terms of the bioeconomic modeling, the biophysical scientists, the economic and social scientists, as is the case with ICARDA. So it helped us to join forces in terms of really expertise and also resources. And another advantage that we as ICARDA have by working with CIHAM IAMM is that the opportunity to deploy PhD students, which can do a great job under mutual supervision, and we have really promising results that we expect in the near future from the PhD students that have already been working in our projects.
Okay, thank you.